in order to mathematically express information about the rate of a chemical reaction, we write what is called a rate law. For the general reaction, A plus B goes to products, we can write the rate law like this. Rate equals K, which is the rate constant, times the concentration of the reactant A raised to some power of X, times the concentration of reactant B raised to a power of Y. We don't know the values of X and Y yet. We need to do some experimentation to determine those values. The exponents X and Y describe how subtle changes in reactants A or B affect the rate of the reaction. X and Y are not necessarily related to the coefficients A and B in the chemical reaction. In addition to whole numbers, exponents X and Y may be negative, they may be zero, or they may be fractions. X and Y must be determined experimentally. And finally, X and Y determine the order of the reaction. Also, the rate constant, K, is a proportionality constant that is determined by the nature of the reactants. And the rate constant is a constant at all conditions except for changes in temperature. Changes in temperature is the only thing that can change the rate constant. The order of the reaction is derived from looking at the exponents in the rate law. So in this example, where we have the rate law given by rate equals K times concentration of bromate ion times concentration of bromine or bromide ion times concentration of hydronium ion squared, we can write down the order of the reaction with respect to each of the reactants. So the reaction order with respect to BrO3- is going to be given by the exponent that goes with BrO3- in the rate law. So in this case, we can see that it is a 1, and so the reaction order with respect to the bromate ion is 1. Similarly, the reaction order with respect to the bromide ion is also 1. And finally, the order with respect to the hydronium ion is 2. And again, these numbers come from the exponents in the rate law, a 1, a 1, and for hydronium ion, it's a 2. And finally, if we sum all of these orders, we can come up with an overall reaction order. And so for this reaction, the overall order is going to be 1 plus 1 plus 2, which is 4. Order of the reaction tells us some information about the disappearance of the reactants. For a first order reaction, the rate law would look something like this. Rate equals rate constant K times reactant to the first power. Since A is raised to the first power, a graph of concentration versus reaction rate should be linear. If the reaction order is 2, it's called a second order reaction. For a second order reaction, we would expect a graph of concentration versus rate to increase exponentially. If the order is 0, that means that the value of A is raised to the 0th power. Anything raised to the 0th power is equal to 1. So in this case, the rate is equal to the rate constant K. For a zero order reaction, a concentration versus rate graph would be completely flat because the reaction rate is not at all dependent upon the concentration of the reactants. In the next video, we're going to look at the experimental determination of the rate law from experimental data.